Hey fellas, it's me, Rika, and I have no idea what to talk about today. So I'm resorting to a last resort. I'm gonna call my buddy. Yeah, let's see what he's got for me. Hey!
What do you want?
I was just wondering if you had any cool games you found, because I know you've been doing that whole QA testing thing. Maybe you got something for me?
QA testing, well, I did test Walking Simulator the other day, dude. It was so much fun.
I was thinking something a little cooler, I guess. You know, something that would capture more of an audience.
Well, I just tested Flight a couple days ago.
No, I mean like something big, you know, like we're talking like event tier, you know?
Oh, you're referring to the... I gotta go, man.
Hey, you doing all right? You seemed a little scared since the last time you hung up on me.
I'm doing okay.
That's great, buddy. Thank you. Let's find out what we're talking about. Egg Hunt 2019. Ah, yes, this one has been under a lot of fire. This time, they're bringing back the concept of spreading eggs out into multiple games, like 2015, with a lobby loosely connecting all of it, and a hub world with some original platforming challenges to appease folks like me. So on paper, this sounds terrible, actually. I have zero expectations for this, but who knows, maybe they can pull through, because last year was so great, so this one must be good too. And this is gonna be the last one, and probably the last event ever, so come on, make it count. Please. 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 I'm begging you. Let's jump into it.
So let me make this clear right now. Not only was this event doomed from the start, from the mere concept of it, but it's also really, really disjointed, and will be difficult to fit into a typical review structure. So let's start by entering the lobby. Ah yes, here we have the white void of infinite loading, which apparently doesn't even go by quickly enough for the cutscene to play properly. Forgive me if I'm jumping the gun a bit here, but even after everything's loaded up, this lobby looks really messy. Look at the stretched out texture on the ground, the ridiculous clash of random colors, the poor attempt at a retro aesthetic, and worst of all, the game portals that got randomly plastered all over the walls. Perhaps we should head over to the hub and figure out what's going on. So, our story begins with three question marks, who informs us that we apparently used to go on adventures together. In another time, we were unstoppable, but now the Eggverse is being undone. Someone has the power of all the eggs, so we gotta regain our memories or something and save the Eggverse. Again, each tear in the Eggverse has an egg hiding within it, which is the plot's excuse for the random third-party games. I won't bore you with any more details, though, so here's how this'll work. Since there's no intended order for the other games, I'll be discussing them in the completely arbitrary order I played them in, and doing them in increments of 10 before having a look at one of the little platforming challenges in the hub. Lastly, a lot of these objectives are incredibly quick, unremarkable, and impossible to make entertaining for a video, so those will be given little to no commentary. So, let's begin with our first egg, McEgger. You touch it in the lobby. Next! Some egg is on display at the Valor City Museum, and you can either become a hero to protect it or a villain to steal it. So let's go! Ow. There's really no point in going in there as a hero, since only villains are allowed to take the egg, so I switched teams, escaped the prison, and took the egg as intended. That ended as quickly as it began. 5 out of 10. Hey, it's you again. It's just like 2015, except this time only one egg is able to fall from the sky, and this time it's locked inside a crystal. All you need to do is get some bombs near said crystal to break it open and collect the demolition expert inside. Lame. 5.5 out of 10. This is a strange choice for an egg hunt, but okay. Now this will take you longer than the first few games. First, become a scientist. Make your way over to the shrinky machine to become a tiny little thing. Painstakingly walk all the way to the power core. Allow it to overheat so the glass can crack. Put on a hazmat suit and jump inside the crack to get the explosion. The creativity on display here is at least acceptable, but still doesn't feel particularly special. Because let's be real, we've all gone through the core meltdown in a game like this at least once. And it's a little disrespectful to the workers here to send out an army of kids trying to blow up their facility all for an egg. 5.5 out of 10. Yet another odd game choice, especially considering its not so great like to dislike ratio, but let's just see what happens. After blasting through the tutorial without learning anything, you need to follow the signs with eggs on them until you reach this hole. Jump down there, traverse some obstacles, and grab this egg.
Oh, wait, I just heard a...
And don't do that. What you're actually meant to do now is run away from the giant bird as it awkwardly slides towards you and escape the hole to get the newborn spotted egg. I suppose this is mildly entertaining, but ultimately forgettable. 5.5 out of 10. All you have to do here is complete a race on the ancient city map before the timer runs out. It's simple enough, especially at the high speed. Right, as I was saying, it's simple enough. It's simple. I said it. See? I did it! And I got the too fast, too egg. 5 out of 10. Touch a dragon and then you get the emerging dragon. That's it.
5 out of 10.
This one's like an egg hunt within an egg hunt. Your job is to find 3 eggs throughout the lobby to unlock pieces of an outfit, then participate in a round while wearing the outfit. Keep in mind that I said participate, as in you literally couldn't fail this if you tried. Doing this will get you the fashionista egg. One odd behavior I noticed about the lobby eggs is that it's seemingly impossible to find all 3 of them in one go, and if this is intentional, it's essentially just a cheap way of getting people to stay in the game longer. This is a tactic we're going to continue seeing many times from here on out, so buckle up. 5 out of 10. What you're supposed to do here is wait for a normal game to pass by and work with your team to win the egg hunt bonus round, but you can just as easily get it by doing absolutely nothing. Either someone else will grab the egg so the whole team gets it, or you can sit alone in a VIP server for a couple minutes and watch the game literally complete itself. Pathetic. 4.5 out of 10. Here we have another interesting game choice, but the quest itself is actually pretty decent. It doesn't start off very well, requiring you to pass a quiz about the game itself as if you would have any desire to play it prior to this event, but once you get through that, it's puzzle time. These puzzles are actually pretty good for the most part, and feel like they easily could have been put into a more traditional egg hunt if they were given some context. I think the one where you have to match the target weight by putting down specific objects is especially creative, since it requires a little something called critical thinking. For completing each puzzle, you get the scaled educator. All in all, this was a decent change of pace, but still nothing too special. 6.5 out of 10. So that's 10 eggs down. Now we have the legal right to play our first platforming section, the egg versus dog. Our goal is to capture this egg, because it contains the power of telekinesis, and no man should have that power. This area has a big focus on the wall climbing ability from the lobby, and it provides a pretty good challenge. Once you make your way to the thingamabob and touch it, you get the telekinetic. Now was that a cool change of pace or what? But let's get back to the garbage. Oh, I thought we were supposed to get back to the garbage, but this is good. Never mind. Escape Room is just doing its usual thing, creating a whole new world of puzzles and beautiful environments just for the event, and I gotta say, this is easily one of the best third-party segments in the whole event. It's challenging, it actually requires you to use more than one person of your brain, and I can't think of a third thing to conclude this sentence with. For completing every puzzle that I refuse to explain because this is a review and not a tutorial, you get the Egg Dini. 7 out of 10. If you ever felt like the previous egg hunts had a distinct lack of road trips to nowhere, then this game is for you. Your goal is to hope that someone gathers the necessary pieces to activate the Eggnado and then drive straight into it and probably die a horrible death. And now you have the Eggle Scout.
Was it worth it? Are you satisfied with the result?
6 out of 10. Bonus points for me getting more fun out of it than I probably should have.
Score a goal with the soccer ball when it turns into an egg. Congratulations, you have the Huvo ball.
5 out of 10. That's right, apparently one high school roleplay wasn't enough for this event. This egg was sadly not nearly as interesting to get as the previous high school egg, because this time you just play 4 random minigames. This little arena will cycle through the 4 games, and you gotta get a good grade on all of them. Disco Spleef, Dodgeball, Thermal Reaction, and a generic sword fight. The only minigame that provides any sort of unique experience is Thermal Reaction, and overall, this is just another pointless quest to forget about immediately after completion. You do it, and you get the book bag. 5 out of 10.
Play on a specific map and power up the teleporter so you can kill the killer. Now you have the Gladiator.
5 out of 10. Have you ever wanted to relive the glory of the 2014 classic Watch Dogs, best known for being an absolute disaster? Well, look no further than Hacker, rocking a beautiful 37% like to dislike ratio. Our story is told by this guy, who is still using the 2010 dialogue box system for some reason. You need to use your radar to make your way to the Matrix letters and hack them, then go back behind where this guy was and go over to the egg. Now you have the egg tricks. Nobody cares. 5 out of 10. Hey, I just talked about this game last time. Here we have a prime example of the core issue with putting prizes in a third-party game. People trying to play the game normally will have their experience heavily disrupted and will end up hindering the people only playing for the prize, depending on how stubborn they are about it. In this case, we have a giant chicken running around terrorizing people, and everyone has to defeat it for it to drop the chicken or the egg. Egg. How goofy. 5.5 out of 10. Your team must collect the most eggs. You get excellent choices. 5 out of 10. The egg of gravitation swiftly teleports around this area and you gotta touch it. 5 out of 10. Now we have 20 eggs. Let's check out our next platforming challenge, Floor 1. Now that the power of telekinesis is in our hands, we gotta make use of it and evade the rising lava by making our own platforms. This time, the egg you're trying to capture has the power of time. I don't know, it'll probably make sense later. All in all, still a fun challenge, but there's not too much to talk about here. While we're on the topic of the platforming things though, let's quickly go over the sponsored section of this event, the Avengers Eggs. We've got representation for all of your favorite super people, like Captain USA, Captain Avengers, Metallic Man, Big Spider, Tor, and most importantly, Grover. These challenges are scattered across the hub and can be accessed by flying over to them in this thing. Each one is catered to the abilities of the hero it's based on, and some pretty unique puzzles are created as a result of this. You'd think the sponsored material would be the least interesting, but funnily enough, it easily beats just about every third-party game here. So with all of that considered, we are now at 27 eggs. Actually, make that 28 because I accidentally found the retro egg. They put the other egg hunt in this egg hunt. Okay? I'll be honest, this might just be the most depressing segment in this event. Not because it's bad, but because it's a grim reminder that we would have been better off just stopping the egg hunts with 2018 rather than going through this mess. It feels so good to be using these controls again, and the dedication they put into being just one small part of this whole thing is a real testament to 15's dignity. I don't see any other segments crafting a whole new world with this much detail all for one egg. Well, besides Robot 64, but we'll get to that later. As for the quest itself, it basically boils down to adjusting some mirrors so they reflect these beams of light onto this force field and break it. Once you've done that, you're free to get the Egg of Origin. Cool, 8 out of 10. Wait for a specific map and grab the egg when it randomly drop, but don't touch the red one because red is bad. Then you get the Chaotic Egg of Catastrophes, 5 out of 10. Wait for specific map with rocket ship and fly away in it. Good job, you have Rocket Eggscape, 5 out of 10. I don't like this one. So you click the giant egg hunt button, and your camera will clip through all of the environment to show you this random tunnel. As it turns out, this tunnel will transport you back in time, and this egg isn't too happy about that. So much so that he felt the need to bring a giant robot into the mix, everyone's favorite device from the 1930s, or whenever this takes place. Now the real battle begins, and all you gotta do is shoot out his seemingly infinite supply of teeth, while having bullets spewed at you the moment you take a slight peek at him, and your body is apparently made up of paper, so just a few bullets is enough to wipe you out entirely. Do you see why I don't like this one now? If you do that, you get the egg off. Bonus points added for doing something unique, but bonus points removed for being really annoying. 5 out of 10. Complete 3 quests that mostly involve making numbers go up and get the flight of the bumble egg, a rather uninteresting addition to what is otherwise a pretty good game. 5.5. Ah, good to see them acknowledging this classic. Just kidding, it's an unauthorized 2018 remake. Why is this here again? So you wait for a specific map, gather up the pink goop, and fill your rocket ship with it until you can finally blast out of there and get the Noob Attack Egg Lander. At least this was something kinda different, but it's still getting a 5.5. This egg literally took me about 25 seconds to get, and the fact that tutorial videos on it can't even seem to break 1 minute really shows that this isn't even deserving of an explanation or review. 4 out of 10. This shy ballerina egg wants your help to become a star dancer. And by help, I mean leeching off of your entirely original performance by making you hold her during it and win a round. After waiting an excruciating amount of time for it to be your turn, the optimal strategy is to get some friends to rig the vote in your favor, no matter how embarrassing of an attempt your avant-garde performance may be. Do this and you get ballerina thing, woo, 5 out of 10. Win a round. Here's another one that was specifically optimized to keep you running around in it for as long as humanly possible. You're given a riddle that hints at the exact order of rides you go on. And yes, that's all you do here. Theme park rides in a specific order, and you walk around. And it really doesn't help that the entrance to every ride is designed to keep you walking around in the most inefficient way possible to make you pay for a fast pass. If you make one mistake here, you have to start all over. So I can't imagine anyone didn't just use a guide. Once you've done that correctly, go through the secret area that just unlocked, find 3 keys, get Roller Eggster, 4.5 out of 10. You don't even deserve to be talked about. Yet another game optimized to keep you going as long as possible. Here you have to wait for a specific minigame to randomly appear and win. I wonder what my rating could possibly be. I think I've gotten to a point where even talking about the cool puzzle platforming stuff is a drag, so I'll make this quick. This one is a nice change of pace from the previous two, focusing way more on the puzzle aspect, and it actually left me stumped a few times. Get cracking technology turret egg, yeah. Get the 3 egg pieces. Ram your car into this giant egg until it breaks. I hope you have insurance. Beat game on medium. Retrieve suitcase. An actually good game? Something to talk about? Okay. This is yet another quest based around collecting a few fragments, but I am giving bonus points for creating a completely unique area for it. Jump your way to the things and you have the egg scream. You guys getting tired of this yet? Nice dislike ratio, 3.9 out of 10. A random zombie will randomly be holding the egg. Randomly. Kill it. Get the egg. Kill this man. The ever so dreadful tradition of the admin egg is back, with a video star egg alongside it. I don't think I need to explain to you how these work, but thankfully, they weren't so painful to get this time because of a few cheap workarounds to them. The biggest one being Egg Hunt 2018. For some reason, the launchers for these eggs were made extremely cheap in the in-game shop, and it's unknown whether this was sheer incompetence or an intentional sabotage on 15's part, but either way, it's another small thing to add to the giant pile of mistakes this event has to offer. Now let's get these last few games over with before diving into the final puzzles. Boy am I glad I played this one after it was patched. This quest is based around riddles leading you to these shards, so it's yet another grab pieces of the thing to get the thing quest. Getting the second shard used to be completely unreasonable, requiring you to aimlessly roam around the giant maze for who knows how long to find this forest in a randomly chosen spot and then go from there. If you do thing right, you get the dadled egg. You make that happen. And with all of that out of the way, we can enter the finale. Just one more puzzle thing and we can fight the boss and get out of here. This one is focused almost entirely on setting your eyeballs on fire. Seriously, I thought the lobby had an awful aesthetic, but this texture is just... why? Why must I stare at this? In terms of actual gameplay, this is still puzzle focused, with some mindless enemies to throw you off because you can't see anything. In all seriousness though, this is still a fine addition to the small roster of original content, but definitely my least favorite. For doing this, you get the missing egg of ARG, and now it's time for the pain. At long last, it's time to fight John Wick. Evil Wick, whatever. So I'm just gonna be blunt immediately. This boss fight is an absolute disaster in every sense of the word. Keep in mind that everything I'm about to show you took place about a week after the event launched, so you can't use the excuse that it was just rough in the beginning but fixed later. According to the man himself, Evil Wick has done a terrible job of keeping himself in check. We've been precarious with our adventuring, and it's almost as though... oh. Okay, I guess he's in a hurry. Beginning with the first phase of this fight, you have exactly one attack to avoid, bombs. Just walk back and forth accordingly and you literally can't lose. Okay, I'm sorry. Once you've done that for what feels like forever, the boss will summon this giant brick for you to climb up and stand there waiting for you to jump on his head. Do this an unnecessary number of times and you've got yourself the second phase. Did that just happen? Now a giant chunk of the ground has been thrown into the lava, and all we need to do is wait for him to summon some more platforms to jump on his head from. He's just standing there, waiting to die. The third phase is basically the same thing, except you have to use telekinesis to lay down the platforms manually. If done correctly, everything will disappear for a good 10 seconds, and then we see Evilwick collapse onto an invisible floor above the lava. From there, we're given the choice to either steal this egg or steal it. I chose to steal it because I want eggs, and apparently that was the wrong choice, because no person should have all that power or something. Then question mark attacks the lower half of your body while you awkwardly stand there in the background, and that's that. However, the good ending actually comes from sealing the egg, and guess what? You have to do that same boss all over again to do that. So I did it again and had significantly more trouble than the first time, but I made it and got both eggs from the fight. And with that, our treacherous journey comes to a close.
So in conclusion, if I could use one word to describe Egg Hunt 2019, I would say depressing. I can't think of a more bland and soulless way they could have possibly gone about this. It feels like they made one last Egg Hunt for the sake of saying they made one, rather than because they actually cared about it. Almost all of the third-party games had zero substance in their objectives, and just felt like they threw in the eggs so they could get a little extra clout on their game. And there was no quality control for what they picked either, with some games' dislike ratios clocking in as low as 39%, or even less. And believe it or not, I would actually say 2015 is better than this, because at least that had the advantage of only being put in 3 games and having multiple eggs in those games, instead of just putting a billion games with one egg in each. Bordy, it's been a long time. Well over a year, actually. And look at you, you're in shambles, just like this event. Honestly, this time around, I don't know if you even deserve death. I think you just need to cease to exist. You took it too far this time, and I must take it even farther.
If there's anything I forgot to say, I will say it here.
Did you know that this year's Egg Hunt had the same amount of development time as last year's? There really is no excuse for this.